Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. New scientific reports are again forcing planetary scientists to rewrite the history of our moon. A new study into the lunar surface contradicts the notion that cratering on the moon occurs incrementally over vast eons of time. A team of scientists studied several thousands of before and after images of the moon's surface, with the visual data covering nearly a million square miles. What they found is that lunar cratering appears to occur at a rate more than 100 times faster than the standard impact model has predicted. The lead author of the study states, "Before the Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter was launched in 2009, we thought that it took hundreds of thousands to millions of years to change the lunar surface layer significantly. We've discovered that the moon's uppermost surface materials are completely turned over in something like 80,000 years. A phys.org report on the study states, "The number of craters is greater than anticipated by standard impact modeling rates used by lunar scientists. The discovery has the effect of giving lunar surface features younger ages. Theory says that a lunar geologic unit should accumulate a certain number of craters of a given size in a million years, for example. But if it turns out that impacts are making craters more quickly, then it takes less time to reach the benchmark number, and the geologic unit is in reality younger than theory predicts." Unfortunately, the only process the scientists have considered for the astonishingly high rate of cratering is impacts from space. However, many recent discoveries reported on this series should provide a doorway to alternative theoretical possibilities. A clue can be found in investigations into dramatic electrostatic dust-raising events on various bodies in the solar system. In August, we reported on a recent NASA-funded study which confirms that electrostatic dust transportation occurs on airless bodies in space. This includes the electrostatic dust storms and electrical discharges that are regularly observed on the moon when it passes through the Earth's magnetotail. As described by NASA scientist Tim Stubbs, Earth's magnetotail extends well beyond the orbit of the moon, and once a month, the moon orbits through it. This can have consequences ranging from lunar dust storms to electrostatic discharges. Could at least some of the new lunar craters be the result of this kind of electrostatic activity? Electrical discharges to solid surfaces and to plates of dust result in cratering and many other geological features familiar to planetary science, as we've repeatedly referenced in these experiments by Billy Elverton. In fact, in recent years, the scientific mainstream has begun to recognize the role of electrical forces in altering the lunar soil. A scientific paper in 2014 explored the possibility that so-called electrical sparking may occur under the moon's surface. But the surprisingly high rate of new lunar craters is only the latest of many unresolved problems with the moon's speculative history. In the 20th century, the discovery of apparently discrepant ages of melted lunar rocks contributed to the invention of an era called the Late Heavy Bombardment. Though astronomers do not roundly accept the theory, and it's not clear where the bombarding objects would have come from. In the Electric Universe theory, as developed by the chief principals of the Thunderbolts Project, the massive cratering on the moon and every heavily cratered planetary body was a product of electrical discharge scarring at an interplanetary scale. Numerous references to past presentations on this theory can be found in the description box of this video. Of course, any new electrical cratering occurring on the moon today would be at a vastly smaller scale than the events that violently scarred its surface from pole to pole. In any case, new scientific data will continue to make it more clear that cratering is not the result of periodic impacts from space over eons of time. Electrical cratering is just one of many new pathways of discovery waiting to be explored in our electric universe. For continuous updates on space news from the Electric Universe, stay tuned to thunderbolts.info.